Hi everyone, we're currently in Marina Del Rey, California, and behind me is a new 2017 Jeanneau 64. This particular yacht, Imagine, was just delivered to its owner, and I wanted to give you another video showing you all the amazing features and benefits that this yacht has to offer.
Here we are starting out the bow, and as you can see, this Philippe Rion hull design is actually very powerful looking just sitting here at the dock. We have a very plumb bow with a full stainless steel reinforced bow forward section located here that's tied in with the inner headsail foiler. We have a very large stainless steel roller that extends the anchor out past the bow, because as you can see, they're maximizing the waterline to its fullest potential, but yet this device really gets the anchor out there so you have real proper anchor angles and what have you to protect the boat. As we move our way back aft, you can see the folding cleats. Those are just absolutely beautiful, a great addition to the yacht, really making it stand out. This particular vessel is a real dark gray with a black inner cove stripe that ties all of the windows together, and it is absolutely beautiful. We have outboard shrouds here that maximize the mast. The mast itself on this particular yacht is a spar craft with three spreaders. We have an inner self-tacking staysail, and we have the larger headsail up forward. This is a black mast that we ordered from the factory, and it has north sails. As we come on aboard the vessel, we're gonna make our way up to the foredeck. And as you can see, the foredeck itself is really nice, flush. We have all the hatches open right now, but when those hatches are closed, this is all one flush area up here that'll accommodate bow cushions. Just forward of that is our sail locker. This could be used as a crew quarters, but in this particular circumstance, we ordered this as a sail locker. Up forward is our anchor locker system and a big, large stowage area that houses the washdown. But as we move up forward, I just want to kind of show you just how extensive this bow piece is and just the beautiful craftsmanship that is done here between all of the elements. Working our way back aft, you're going to also see the Jeanneau tracks on the side deck, our self-tacking track here up on the foredeck, just in forward of the mast. One thing that I want to point out is the Antal halyard adjustment system here. So what you see here is these are the halyards. They're adjusted to their proper tension. This is the halyard winch. So what you have is a short halyard that clips right onto this hook, and that's how you adjust your tension. So what it does is it puts all the load factor here instead of distributing it through blocks all the way into the aft section of the boat, and also just really tidies everything up. So it's a great addition to the vessel. We have, this is the salon overhead opening hatches. And this that we're looking at is the factory canvas. The factory canvas, we have done one modification. We've upgraded this to the Makrelon glass. So this makes it look like a windshield. As you can see, the isinglass just above that. But the Dodger is quite nice. It is set up till it does collapse. We have built-in grab handles that are stainless with leather wrapping on it. We have a removable connector that goes to the arch where the main sheet is attached to. By having the arch here on this particular yacht, because the cockpit is so large, what it does is it enables you to have the attachment point here. But if you do not prefer the arch, it will attach in the middle of the cockpit. But I think this is the way to go for this particular yacht. As we move back aft into the cockpit, you're going to see that we have the working winches here, and then this beautiful aft lounge area here at the back of the boat. Starting off at the port helm, we have our GPS controls, autopilot, we have our repeater, we have our fusion stereo controller, we have our underwater light switch controllers, and then obviously lighting and switches for deck light, spreader light, courtesy, bimini lights, and so forth. Just forward of the helm, you're going to see we have our general winches and our working winch up forward of that, both two speeds. They do have all of a nice area for all of the sheets and halyards to go into. Next to this is the cockpit seating area. This could be lounged down, or you can use it as seats. We have a refrigerator here. We have a sink on the opposite side. At the starboard helm, we have our engine throttle controls, our stern and bow thruster controls, our windlass chain counter control, our engine display. We have a 12 volt outlet. We have the autopilot control and the GPS plotter here as well. Just forward of that, our general winches, our working winch, that's also rewindable. But one thing that this particular yacht has that I think is a must, it's a very expensive option, but is the main sheet captive winch. So I can control the main sheet with just a push of the button here, allowing to let the mainsail out or bringing it back in. Phenomenal option. As we move up forward, you're gonna see, again, this is a massive cockpit. We have two cockpit tables. As you can see, this is in the lower position. This is all done electronically with a switch there at the helms, and you can raise it up. They do have filler cushions, and you can put them both down if you so desire. But what I'm doing is just displaying one up and one down. There's a massive stowage compartment located here as well. Talking about stowage compartments, directly behind us is access into the garage, and then we have a dedicated life raft locker, or you can use it with the electric grill. That's an option, that the electric grill pops up out of there, and that's what this particular yacht has on it. So again, the bimini itself, the canvas, you know, let me just give you a close-up of the stainless work that's done from the factory. I mean, huge thick tubing, beautiful welds, and it was just very well done. So that's why we decided to use the factory canvas. A lot of thought and engineer went into it. The companionway itself slides down. So you can see that it is in a really nice lowered area here. We have a nice gradual walk down into the salon of the vessel. So here, looking at the salon of the vessel, we have a beautiful, massive U-shaped seating off to starboard. We have the electric table option that raises up and down, turns it into a coffee table. It actually slides out, slides back in as you so desire. We have the removable dendon chairs that you can slide around the table itself. Beautiful ports here on the cabin top, all LED lighting, LED rope lighting above the built-in grab handles, four overhead opening hatches, and then off to the port side, we have the huge built-in sofa love seat, and then our galley just aft of that. Let's start out with the galley. We have a really nice stainless steel sink located here. This particular owner went with the dishwasher, the Miele dishwasher. We have the wine cabinet cooler. There is lots of drawers and shelving throughout. Beautiful molded Corian countertops with the nice beveled edges to them. Three burner stove and oven. We have a convection oven. We have a freezer with ice maker, and then a refrigerator above that. There's not lots of just pantry storage and drawers throughout the yacht. As we make our way back aft, there is a day head and shower access here. So you have a full walk-in shower. The shower itself is quite nice. Plexiglass door that closes that off. Beautiful teak bowl sink here, and Japsco quiet flush toilets. Again, the attention to detail from the hinges, the woodwork, the inlay of the leather in the doors, the door handles, everything you touch and feel on this yacht is just absolutely stunning. Working our way back aft, this is the double bed version. We have a big hatch here with a side port, the hatch overhead, and then again, it's just really tastefully done. We've installed a TV system with a you know, satellite receiver just down below that. You have your own air conditioning, hanging locker controls, and so forth. As we walk our way back through the galley, and we're going to show you the starboard side of the vessel. So this is the optional double bunk. So it's a really nice area here. So double bunk beds. We have an opening shades to give you a visual at the port here overhead, and then there's an opening port just above my head. We have engine access. Look at the sound shield, look at the density of that. We have our Volvo engine here. All of our pumps, our air conditioning pumps, everything is located in this particular room to keep all of the noise down and making the yacht super quiet. Walking back aft to our VIP stateroom, and the reason I call this the VIP stateroom is you do have your own separate shower, head compartment. Again, really nice Corian countertops, great shower access there. But you do have a queen size bed with a nice bench seating here. There is a opening shade here to give you access out of this port, and overhead access as well for visual. Samsung television, and again, another hanging locker, drawers. It is just a very well laid out aft VIP. Now, as we make our way back up through the salon, I'm going to show you the master stateroom. This obviously is the master cabin forward layout. There's a couple different cabin configurations, but this owner chose this just for its design. But lots of shelving, drawers, hanging locker. We have a aft facing desk, a vanity, nice bench seat here, and then a full center line berth that has access to both sides. Look at this massive headboard with light fixtures, lights. I mean, it's just really, really impressive. Got all the attention to detail. We've done the flat screen Samsung TV up on the forward bulkhead. There's a beautiful picture located there. Nice, you know, aviation shades that lift up for you to have good visual. 12-volt fans all the way up forward is a full beam head and shower. So these are the Japsco toilets. Lots of shelving, hanging locker space there for towels and what have you. We have a full walk-in shower. Again, this is really impressive. Two overhead opening hatches as well. And then again, everything is just trimmed out to the finest, from the hardware that you see, from the fixtures. You know, everything is just is so tastefully done. Even underneath the bed, there's pull-out drawers. You can see the access here to, you know, the side of the berth, so you can get in it. But this is a very, very impressive forward master stateroom. And again, it's very unique to have a bed where the head is actually aft and your feet go up forward. So it's truly set up, you know, like a mega yacht. Well, I hope you found this short video to be helpful and informative. If you would like additional information on the Jeanneau 64 or any of the Jeanneau product, if you're looking to buy or sell a yacht, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. Thank you again. I look forward to hearing from you, and most of all, hopefully earning your business.